Welcome to the Finding Wisdom Show. Are you ready for Christmas yet? It's the time of giving and sharing, and I have a wonderful, wonderful panel of guests today to share with us some of the wonderful artwork and some of the wonderful events that they've been able to share their artwork at. I have with me today the PR person from the Art of Tarang, and I have with me the two co-founders of the Art of Tarang, and I have with me the one and only Chris Tarango, wonderful artist. We have so much wonderful things to share with you today. I want to thank you guys for being here today.
Thank you so much.
Now, let's get a little history from you, Mark. Tell us a little bit about how this came about.
Well, basically, I met Renato because the company that he was working for was looking to replace a very old Toshiba copier. And I was fortunate to receive the phone call and made an appointment and go see him. And we developed a great friendship from that initial beginning. I didn't get the order, but I built a friendship around what he was doing. He kind of like invited me to his studio, which at the time was downtown in Manhattan. And I came down, and what the concept was very intriguing. It's about how to create a warm environment with people you never met before by discussing their art or the art exhibit, which was very intriguing to me because the worst thing to do is when you go on an appointment and it's cold, you don't know where to begin. But by discussing someone's art, such as Chris's, everyone has a different interpretation and you can share that. And then once completed, maybe you can pick up on a conversation at a later date and go on, hey, you know, we had a great time at that show and everything, and then make an appointment and discuss. Maybe you have something, a product or a service that might fit their particular needs. And that's how we got together.
Wow, fantastic. Tell me a little bit more, Renato. Tell us about how Art of Tarang came about and what your hopes are.
I think the Art of Tarango was quite interesting in itself because when I met Chris through a friend of mine, I wasn't expecting such dedication from an artist. I mean, the guy bloody traveled, drove from Texas to Manhattan, and I thought that was
awesome.
What made the show like fantastic. You know, crazy Texan driving all the way like from where he is to do a show in Manhattan. That shows a lot of guts, and I thought that was one hell of a presentation in itself as a press release. And I think he deserved all the accolade that he got that night. Everybody had a great time. You were there.
Oh, that was a wonderful night.
It was a lot of fun.
And, had a lot of fun. There were prizes given out and wine and good food.
I think the art exhibition is not, I mean, we kind of turned it more into a show than just a gallery presentation.
Do you have some pictures of the event?
Yes, I believe we
can. Can we see some pictures?
Sure.
Clips?
Yes.
Tell us more while we're seeing the images.
The whole aim of the show is not just to have a presentation of the artwork, but also to entertain the guest. And so hence we had a lot of shows that a lot of the people had we had raffles and whatnot.
Raffles.
With Chris's show as well too is unique in a sense because it was the first one where we had a major sponsor actually sponsor the show, WDII, and that was a tremendous lift for our profile, having somebody like WDII support an emerging artist like Chris. I mean, after all, we're all about trying to promote the small guys and make them be a little bit more connected with the bigger guys. And so, Mark, help me out here.
Well, basically, the whole thing is we can take any particular space and pop up and gallery, take out everything in there, and when you get done with it, it doesn't look anything like it was.
Yeah.
And you put up the art, you showcase it, you hand out some little tidbits of food, little wine, you mingle with all the people, you warm them up, and then the next thing you know, you have a itinerary of a plan of what the event's going to be, and then you go on with that. You do a little bit of a raffle, you do bidding on the art pieces, certain selected pieces, which one
so sold. It gives artists a chance to get the exposure in a good setting where people are able to be relaxed, have fun, and talk about art.
Mm-hmm. An unknown artist,
yeah.
Basically.
So it gives them a chance to be
so that they'll be
recognized.
Recognized into an actual gallery. And that's what the whole setting was about.
Wow.
And being that Chris came up from Texas, he's unknown as far as Manhattan.
So we should follow him. We should follow you, Chris, and see your walk, your journey, and see what happens.
Yeah.
And how it goes. Because, I mean, we went to this event. It was really great. I don't know. Do you guys have the clips ready yet? We had a wonderful time. And his artwork, not only did you have a wonderful time, but sometimes you want to see a good artist. You want to see that they have good work. And he was very good with his, well, I'm not that an expert in art, but he had very good color coordinating with his style. His paintings. What inspired you to paint, Chris?
Mainly the things around me, people around me. That's pretty much what inspires my paintings for the most part.
Because you could tell that the paintings had some feeling. Whichever art piece that, did you bring a piece with you today?
No, I believe we brought some, I think we have a slideshow and got some prints as well.
Okay, that's what we're working on right now to show. But he did extremely, I mean, you have to go to one of the events that they have. Do you have any events coming up right now?
We just had one on October the 28th, mm-hmm. which is the Off-World Exhibition. Again, the slides are this is the Tarango show, the Art of Tarango in June. Right. So here, Chris, you can see him flexing his muscles, which... Well, actually, no, Linda.
But actually, Chris, tell us about the painting behind us.
That picture is a painting I did. It's about 5 foot by 4.5 feet. It's actually a painting of my wife playing the guitar.
Your wife, right?
Mm-hmm.
Beautiful picture.
Thank you.
And that is the person from WDII?
Yeah, that's a sponsor. That's the owner of WDII, an international like real estate company that is sponsoring Chris. So he's really happy as well.
Wow.
There's Yuko.
That's your wife.
My wife Yuko again.
For the artwork.
Beautiful. And these are some of the people that were at the event?
Mm-hmm.
The little lady is my co-host Ashley, and I forget his
Brandon.
Name. Brandon. Yeah, Brandon. Okay. Yeah.
That was interesting.
These are the pieces that sold on Chris's show. So
these are some of his work?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. His work. This is the centerpiece, which are... I mean, you wouldn't look at it, you wouldn't know it there, but they're skateboards. Like, is it six skateboards? And this is, we're moving now towards the Off-World Exhibition, which was on October. We just had it. And this is the French artist.
Oh,
the,
wow.
The previous to that
very
was
nice.
Like, these were the American artist that we had. Mm-hmm. The show.
So it's like a collaboration of different artists from all over the world.
Correct.
Well,
right?
We had an artist from Paris.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We had a show over at Resolution on 36th Street and up on, what was that, 46?
Aspen Social Club, yeah.
At 27. So it was all done live format and Skype, all collaborating together. So we did basically an auction at all three locations.
Nice, nice.
So you'll see here, like on the next slide, how we actually did it when it comes back on.
Okay.
So we have three independent art exhibits all happening at the same time, and they're all interconnected via like the internet. And I'm hosting from one site. I'm able to direct like the show everywhere else. And going forward, that's how my shows will be, where we will have international like presence as well. It was very successful when we did the show. The French were very happy. Their PR guy stayed till 4 o'clock in the morning, basically, like to participate in the show. And as we go into the next slide, this is our wonderful Amanda Lowe, and you can see her performing her violin to the crowd in Paris. And these are the pieces that were auctioned off, and the one to the right actually sold off. I wouldn't have been able to do anything without Amélie. She is instrumental in making the Paris exhibition happen.
Fantastic. This is so great. Tell me a little bit more about your public relations.
You need a glass of water?
Here?
a little bit. I met Renato through just networking.
How are you?
I met Renato through like networking, and I called him up. It's kind of like really weird how it all happened. It's kind of like what do you call it? Like serendipity or something like that. Like,
yes, that's when things work.
Yeah, serendipity. So maybe he was like sending out some transmission through the radio waves or whatever.
Okay.
But I called him, and then I went to the event, and I saw the event, and I was just like, it was really, really interesting, and then we just kind of talked about how we could promote this. As Renato said, that you know, you can have an event, but what does it mean if the press are not there? Like, it's just an event. Mm-hmm. So we've been talking and discussing and making articles to be put into select publications to talk about the event, to get press for the event, because, you know, what is it?
It's a very important part of putting all this together.
Yes. Yeah, we've been very fortunate, like, to have Jay come on board and, like, actually assist us in terms of promoting what we're doing.
Excellent. So,
it's definitely, like, a learning experience. We have these conversations, like, I talk to Renato and I ask him, as a public relations person, you have a billion questions that you have to ask so that you could hone everything in, so you can really get a good idea of what you're trying to do. And the relationship of the press and an artist is very interesting. I don't know, like.
Well, how everything integrates, I think, is what makes this an awesome idea to actually follow Chris, because a lot of times you see a lot of shows, you don't see anybody following an artist on his path to success.
Right.
And an artist, a thriving artist, they go through a lot of hardships before they actually make it. You only see the good part when you see the successful artists that actually, you know, are successful. But what happens before that? You don't really, you know? So that I feel that we're going to do more together as a team where we could follow him and follow your journey with him, the way your journey goes with him and yours as well, and integrate it also with the rest of the world. I think that what you guys are doing is wonderful.
I think we need more big businesses to actually get on board supporting the emerging artists. I think that's the future. I mean, if they're looking for an alternative to what's going on around here, around the world, I think it's about time that big business start to look at these little guys and supporting them. Perhaps, you know, by giving, we might be able to stimulate this economy back and set an example for the world. I mean, do it here in New York first and see how it works. So that's the challenge, I guess, for all of us. I mean, you know.
Well, in the spirit of giving and sharing ideas and thoughts, because we are in the time of Christmas right now, wish everybody a Merry Christmas from the Finding Wisdom show and the Art of Tarang. What it is that sharing information, following talent, help boost the economy, help someone that's trying to do something positive, invest in that. There's so much negativity around today that I think what you guys are doing is awesome. Go ahead, Mark.
Well, basically, Renato and I are both, I'm sure Chris and Jay are as well, in a lot of different charity organizations. I know Renato is with White Wave. I'm with the Knights of Pythias, as well as my Temple Zion in Long Beach, New York. Jay, are you with any particular organizations I'm not aware of?
Just the New City Gallery, and I do public relations for different organizations and companies. Also write articles and stuff.
What about you, Chris? Are you in any charities?
I started a nonprofit called Austin Loves Japan to benefit the earthquakes and the tsunami disasters in March of this year. And that was pretty su-